Anneliese Michel, popularly known as Anneliese Michel, was born on September 21, 1952, and died on July 1, 1976. She was a German girl who underwent a staggering 67 Catholic exorcism rituals in the year leading up to her death. It is important to note that Anneliese Michel had previously been diagnosed with epileptic psychosis, in particular caused by temporal lobe epilepsy, and had a history of psychiatric procedures, which unfortunately proved ineffective. At the age of 16, Anneliese Michel had a severe seizure, culminating in a diagnosis of psychosis associated with temporal lobe epilepsy. In the following months, she was also diagnosed with depression and subsequently underwent treatment in a psychiatric facility. Her condition worsened when she reached the age of 20, marked by growing intolerance of various religious subjects and the appearance of auditory hallucinations. Despite constant treatment, her mental health continued to deteriorate, which led to suicidal tendencies and the manifestation of additional alarming symptoms that required further treatment. Unfortunately, taking psychiatric medications for 5 years has not led to a noticeable improvement. At this stage, desperate for lack of progress, Anneliese Michel and her family became convinced that she was under the influence of demon possession. Consequently, they turned to the Catholic Church for intervention, initially facing rejection. However, after the intervention of two priests who received permission from the local bishop in 1975, a series of exorcism sessions was initiated. Unfortunately, the doctor's consultation stopped, and Anneliese Michel gradually refused to eat, eventually becoming a victim of malnutrition and dehydration after 67 long exorcism sessions. Legal consequences followed. Anneliese Michel's parents and two Roman Catholic priests were found guilty of negligent homicide and sentenced to 6 months in prison, commuted to 3 years probation, and a monetary fine. Bishops publicly retracted their claim of her obsession during a conference in a last-ditch attempt to clear their name. Respected priest Father Ernst Alt made an observation that differs from the generally accepted view of epilepsy, noting that Anneliese Michel did not exhibit the typical characteristics associated with this disease. According to his close observations, he did not witness any seizures while communicating with her. Instead, Alt's father was inclined to believe that Anneliese was struggling with a much more serious ailment, demon possession. Driven by this conviction, he begged the local bishop to give permission for an exorcism. In a touching letter written by Michel in 1975 to Father Alt, she expressed her sense of unworthiness and deep need for improvement, asking him to pray for her. She also confided in him, telling him of her desire to endure suffering for the sake of others, although she acknowledged the cruel nature of her ordeal. The turning point came in September 1975, when Bishop Joseph Stengel gave permission to Father Arnold Renz to perform an exorcism, adhering to the Ritual Romanum, a prescribed Roman Catholic ritual. This marked the beginning of a series of exorcism sessions, the first of which will take place on September 24th. Anneliese Michel increasingly voiced her fervent desire to atone for the transgressions of modern youth and alleged apostasy among the modern church clergy. At her request, her parents stopped consulting with medical practitioners and relied solely on exorcism rituals. In about 10 months, in 1975 and 1976, 67 exorcism sessions were conducted, which were usually conducted weekly and lasted up to 4 hours each. Unfortunately, as her ordeal unfolded, Anneliese Michel began to refuse to eat. On July 1st, 1976, she died at her home. In the autopsy report, her death is attributed to malnutrition and dehydration, the terrible consequences of almost a year of starvation during the rites of exorcism. In an emaciated state, she weighed only 30 kilograms, 66 pounds, had fractures in her knees due to constant kneeling, which made her unable to move independently, and she reportedly died of pneumonia. After a thorough investigation, the public prosecutor stated that Anneliese Michel's death could have been prevented just a week before her tragic death. Subsequently, in 1976, charges of negligent homicide were brought against Michel's parents and priests Ernst Alt and Arnold Arendts. Erich Schmidt-Leichner, a well-known defense lawyer at the Nuremberg trials, represented the parents, while the church assumed responsibility for the priest's legal costs. Surprisingly, the state recommended that none of the accused parties be imprisoned. Instead, the proposed punishment for the priests was a monetary fine. At the same time, the prosecution argued that the parents should be released from punishment, given the enormous suffering they had already suffered, a legal provision of German criminal law. On July 14, 1977, a newspaper article reported that two Roman Catholic priests had been formally charged with negligent homicide in connection with the exorcism-related death of Anneliese Michel. The subsequent trial, which began on March 30, 1978, in the district court, attracted considerable attention. Medical experts testified that Michel did not suffer from obsession, arguing that the manifestations attributed to demonic influence were actually psychological consequences of her strict religious upbringing and epilepsy. In a landmark statement, Dr. Richard Roth, to whom Alt's father sought medical help, allegedly informed Michel during the exorcism that there is no injection against the devil, Anneliese. Defense lawyer Schmidt-Leichner defended the legality of exorcism, stressing that the German Constitution guarantees citizens the unrestricted exercise of their religious beliefs. To bolster their case, the defense presented recordings of exorcism sessions, some of which were said to be demonic arguments, highlighting their claim that Anneliese Michel was indeed possessed. Both priests claimed that the demons clearly identified themselves as Lucifer, Cain, Judas Iscariot, Belial, Legion, Hitler, and Nero, among other infamous figures. They further claimed that Michel was freed from demonic influence by exorcism shortly before her death. Bishop Stengel, who approved the exorcism, did not testify in court and said he was unaware of Michel's alarming deterioration in health. In April 1978, Michele and two priests were found guilty of negligent homicide, although they received suspended prison sentences. They were also instructed to share the financial burden associated with the litigation. The severity of these sentences exceeded the recommendations of the prosecutor, since the priests had to pay only fines, and the parents, although found guilty, were asked to release them from punishment due to the aforementioned mitigating circumstance. An age-old exorcism rite sanctioned by the church has attracted public and media attention to the case. Author John M. Duffy claims that mental illness was misidentified in this case. Subsequently, during a conference held several years later, the German bishops officially retracted the statement that Anneliese Michel was possessed.